Pastor Stacy Sawyer. God bless you.
Remain standing. Father God, in the name of Jesus, just once again, God, we want to tell you thank you. We thank you for your goodness and your mercy. We thank you for your loving kindness. We thank you, Lord God, for being God all by yourself. And besides you, Lord, there is no other God. We thank you for this appointed time, Lord God. We thank you for your presence even now, God. We pray, God, that you will move by your power and move by your spirit, God, in the name of Jesus. God, we're looking for you to set free, heal, and deliver, God, in the mighty and matchless name of Jesus. God, I pray in the name of Jesus that you would touch every person, every soul under the sound of my voice, God. In the name of Jesus, do, God, what only you can do, God. In the name of Jesus, prepare our hearts, oh God. In the name of Jesus, to receive your word on today, God, that we can live thereby, Lord God, that you can be glorified. God, we love you. We thank you and we praise you, God, in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. We do give honor to God. He is my life. Amen. We give honor to our co-pastor, Elder A. Sawyer, amen, to our assistant pastor, Prophetess Jones, amen, to our youth pastor, Elder A.V., amen. We bless God and we thank God for our deaconess, amen, for our mothers on today, amen, our business administrator, Sister Searcy, amen. God is good, always good. We just bless God and we thank God for what he's doing. We thank God for each and every heart, amen, our Sister Sawyer, amen, for being on her post on today, Lord God, and we just love the Lord. Amen. And I thank God for each and every one of you. Amen. So nice to look out and see Mother Rohan and Mother Sawyer. Amen. In the midst. Amen. God is good. Amen. And he's certainly worthy of our praises. He already been moving. I know you. Hey! My God, he already been moving. Amen. And we just bless God and we thank God. Amen. For his move on this morning, amen. He's just, I love the Lord because he first loved me. Amen, amen. And I'm praying that the saints of God and those that are listening online can hear, amen, on Zoom and on the Facebook. Prayerfully, you can hear us pretty good. We're testing out sound and different things are going on. So, but we bless God. We thank God that things are as well as they are. Amen. Amen. I won't be before you longer than the Lord would allow. Amen. I thought Elder A.V. was going to read the passage of scriptures when he said he booked the book of Ephesians. I said, God, I thank you. And he touched on that word faith anyhow. And so we just bless God and we thank God. Amen. I'll be in the same book. Amen. For chapter 6. Amen. Ephesians chapter 6, and I'm only going to read one scripture, one verse out of that. Ephesians chapter 6, amen, and we're going to be reading the 16th verse. And when you have it, if you can and you will, stand to your feet. I guess you can only stand to your feet unless you stand on your head. Amen. I'm going to ask you to stand, and we're going to read it in concert on this morning. Amen. It's been a while since we did that, but I just feel like when you read it, you know, for yourself, it just seemed to get in your spirit better. Mm-hmm. Amen. The Bible says that faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Amen. Yes. So we're going to read it in concert. Is that all right? Amen. Amen. Come on, let's read verse 16. Above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith ye shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked. Amen. That's it. Amen. You can take your seats. We bless God and we thank God for his written word. Amen. For the last few days, amen, the word faith just kept ringing in my spirit. And the Lord reminded me of this word he had gave me a few years ago. And he let me know that it's for such a time as this. Amen. So today we're going to talk a little on the subject shield of faith. Thank you. Amen. It's something. Oh, yeah. I tell you, something about faith and exercising that faith. Mm-hmm. Amen. Amen. And so we find, amen, this shield of faith that we're going to be talking about today. It's the fourth part of the piece of armor that the Apostle Paul mentions here in Ephesians chapter 6. Mm-hmm. My glasses keep fogging up because the Lord done moved, done had his own way. Amen. So it got hot. We in the fire. I don't know about it, but the fire moving. Amen. Amen. You know when you have that air conditioning, and then you have and God moving by His power, doesn't it? Yeah. It causes some condensation. Y'all know about that. Amen. So we just bless God. Amen. Oh yeah, we in it. Hey, my God. I could take off dancing again right now. Amen. So we just bless God and we thank God. I'm going to try to get through this, but if the Lord say something different, y'all know your pastor, I'm out. Amen. I'm just going to move. I'm going to move with the Spirit because it's his business. Is that all right? Amen. Amen. But in this, we're talking about this fourth piece of the armor. Amen. And as we study this out, amen, while we find the whole armor in this chapter, amen, it's the whole thing is listed in the New Testament. If you go back and you read, you will find that it's evident, amen, that in the Old Testament, amen, I'm talking about this shield of armor, it's actually evident, thank you, God, in the Old Testament, amen. And so some of you might be saying, wait, Pastor, we read it in Ephesians. I didn't read where they had the armor of God in the Old Testament. So what are you talking about? I want to let you know, when we read the story of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, oh my God, it is quite evident that they were in possession of the shield of faith. Oh yes. Thank you, God. Amen. In the book of Daniel, amen, chapter 3, we read where the king, amen, talking about Nebuchadnezzar, amen, he had set up a 90-foot high statue, a golden statue. Y'all imagine what that thing looked like when the sun hit it? 90 feet high, golden statue. Amen. Amen. So he sets this thing up, amen, that if they, at the sound of the music, oh, come on, y'all read the story. Amen. All were to fall down and worship this statue. And the music would play not just one time, but various times throughout the day. And every time they heard the music, they were to bow down, oh my God, and worship this statue. Amen. So out of everybody in the nation, there were three Hebrew boys. They were the only ones. I'm going to say it this way. They were the only ones that the Bible mentions as courageous enough to stand against this decree. Yeah. Come on, hear somebody. Yeah. Amen. Yeah. And I wonder why that is. I wonder why they were the only ones that were courageous enough to stand against a royal decree. It is my conviction that the shield of faith made the difference. Oh my God. Come on here. When you have faith, and the shield of faith, oh my God, thank you, God. And you know how to operate it, you know how to exercise it, you know how to walk in faith, oh my God. Folk can say what they want to say, my God. They can say what they want to say, and you will not bow down. Thank you, Jesus. So it's my conviction that the shield of faith made the difference. Yeah. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego had a faith in God.
Yeah. Come on.
That allowed them to stand up to the king.
Yeah.
Come on here, somebody. On. Even at, catch this, right, at the threat of death.
Catch that.
Yeah. So somebody missed it. They stood up to the king, even at the threat of death. Thank you, God. Those that refuse, what are you talking about, the threat of death? Well, those that refuse to obey. Those who wouldn't bow down. The Bible says that they will be thrown into a fiery furnace. And when the king heard that they had disobeyed. He gave them, catch this, he gave them, so he thinks, another chance. He said, listen, I'm going to give y'all another chance. If you bow down at the sound of the music,
come on.
Fine. But if you don't, I'm going to throw you into the fiery furnace. But they wouldn't bow down. Catch this. This is what they said. Now he said, listen, you going in. I'm going to give you a chance. When this music play, you bow down and you worship that statue. If you do that, I'll spare your life. But if you don't, you going in.
Go ahead.
Look what they said. They said, oh, not even king. They said, oh, Nebuchadnezzar. They ought to tell you something right there. They said, oh, Nebuchadnezzar, we are not careful to answer thee in this matter. They said, if it be so, our God, whom we serve, is able to deliver us from the burning fiery furnace. And he will deliver us out of thy hand. Now they get it with a small K. Oh, king. Amen. But if not,
come on.
They said, be it known unto thee, O king, that we will not serve thy gods, nor worship the golden image which thou hast set up. In other words, our God is able to deliver us from execution. But even if he don't, even if he don't save us, from the fiery furnace, one way or another, he will deliver us out of your hands. Okay. Woo! Thank you, Jesus. Somebody ought to shout faith in this place. You know the story. Y'all know it. And so they were eventually thrown into the fiery furnace. But God miraculously, y'all go read it for yourself. Y'all know it. They walked around. One looked like the Son of God. Y'all read it. And God miraculously delivered them unharmed out of a furnace that was, catch this, that was seven times hotter than the norm. Thank you, God. Seven times hotter than the norm. Thank you, Jesus. God, we bless you. They came out. Catch this. They came out of that furnace. They didn't even smell.
That's it.
Like smoke.
Jesus.
not a hair on their head was singed. Thank you, Jesus. They came out with victory and with power. Come on here, somebody. Exercising your faith in Jesus will enable you to stand up. It will enable you to withstand stuff.
Come on.
Circumstances.
Come on.
Issues that are seven times harder than the normal person. My God.
Come on.
Thank you, Jesus. Faith.
Yes.
The shield of faith. You can go through something that you won't even look like.
That's it.
Or smell like.
Come on.
What you've been through.
Yes.
The shield of faith.
Yes.
Now, up until this point,
come on.
Paul describes the armor of God as something. I love this. I love this.
Come on.
He describes it as something we put on.
Jesus.
Amen.
Come on.
Like a belt of truth. We put on a breastplate. We put it on of righteousness. Amen. And we put on the shoes of the gospel of peace. And once we put them on, they essentially hold themselves
go ahead
in place.
Yeah.
Like I got these shoes on, and these shoes, I don't need nobody to hold my shoes in place, you know. Once I put them on, they're on.
Yeah.
They essentially just fit.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So every piece that he talks about before we get to the shield, you put it on. And it essentially holds themselves up.
Yeah.
But the shield of faith is different. The shield is not something we put on, but something Paul tells us to take up.
Yes.
I like it if don't nobody like it. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. In other words, it's something that we are required to raise. Amen. Shout faith. Come on, y'all help me preach. Now, just strapping the shield of faith onto our arm, it's not enough. And it won't do us any good unless we put some effort into holding it up and using it. Thank you, God. Amen?
Amen.
You got to put some effort in this. You got to put some effort into exercising your faith. Come on here. It don't just happen. You have to take it up. Amen. The Roman shield, which is also called the scutum, wasn't the standard medieval type of shield that most of us picture in our minds when we hear the word shield. Come on here, y'all help me preach. Some of these shields, catch this, were about 3.5 feet. A shield.
Yeah.
We measured this last week, didn't we?
Yes, we did.
And it's about 3.5 feet. High.
Jesus.
Amen? And almost 3 feet wide.
Jesus.
Take it. I'm talking about a shield. Amen? And because of its size, the soldiers were afforded great protection from their enemy. So it's just as wide as it is high.
Wow.
Thank you, Jesus. Amen? And so this shield had a slight, it had a curve to it. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. And it enabled the soldiers, amen, to deflect.
Go ahead.
Woo! The arrows. Amen. Without fully feeling the force because it had a curve to it. Amen. Thank you, my God and my Savior. Amen. So they didn't feel the full force of the attack.
Come on,
somebody missing it. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Not only that, the shields, they were rubbed down with, they were rubbed down with or anointed with oil. Amen. Which caused these fiery darts, oh my God, to spring back or rebound or bounce off. Oh my God. Amen. The anointing. Can I help somebody? The anointing in your life, my God, along with your shield of faith, can cause whatever the enemy shoots your way to return right back. To return right back. Oh my God. To him. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. And here's something else I really like about this shield. Y'all got to take up your shield. What shield? Your shield of faith. You got to take it up. Because here's something else about this shield. This shield, at the center of it, there was a knob in the center of this shield. Y'all heard me say this before. In the center of this knob, of this shield was a knob. And the knob was called the boss. Okay, I'm going to say that again. In the center of the shield was a knob. And the knob was called the boss. And because of this boss, amen, it was able to deflect even more vicious blows. Amen. And function. function in a limited offensive capacity as a means of knocking.
Go ahead.
Oh, boy. In a means of, I wish I had the energy to preach this. But you, they were able to use it to knock the enemy back. Because they, see, what they did was they held on to the knob.
Go ahead.
They held on to the knob. Thank you, God. And they just pushed him back.
Jesus.
Oh, my God. So what did they took up the shield. And in the center of this shield of faith is Jesus.
Yes.
And if you just hold on to the balls, then you will be able, no matter what's advancing your way, as long as Jesus is the center of your faith, hold on to the balls and just manifest.
I like it if y'all don't like it. You gotta take out that shield of faith and trust God, knowing that the boss is in the center of it all. Oh my God. Come on, shout faith. Come on, shout faith. Thank you, God. So Paul says, take up the shield of faith. So then what is faith?
Jesus.
Take your time.
Okay, well, I'll tell you what faith is. It's in the book. Hebrews 11 and 1. It says, now faith is the substance of things hoped for. The evidence of things not seen. I got to stop. I got to park right here. I got to serve the enemy notice. Y'all don't mind. Because sometimes God will allow you.
Come on.
To detect something in the atmosphere.
Go ahead,
yes,
go ahead.
And I detect
go ahead.
That the enemy wants to try to take my focus.
Yeah.
Let me tell you something.
Come on.
This shield of faith that I done took it up. Yes, prophetess, sir. I took it up this morning.
Yes, sir.
So regardless of what the body says.
Come on.
The box.
Yes, sir.
Is in the center of what's going on right now. And in the name of Jesus, I push it out.
Knock
it up. Get out.
Jesus.
Prophet said, go ahead, but I'm going to show y'all something.
Jesus.
Because God is real.
Yes.
The power of God is real.
Yes.
So I just want him to know. I don't want him to get confused.
Do it.
Amen. I want him to know who I trust and who's working in me.
Yes.
So if y'all want to, y'all can come, but I want to show
Jesus.
Testimony, so y'all gonna know what I'm talking about.
Yes, sir.
But I'm gonna put this out there just so he will know.
That's right.
I will live.
Yes, you have to.
I will live.
Yes,
and not die.
Say it.
To declare the works of God.
Say it.
And can't no devil in hell. Take up your shield. And no matter what
can't. I'm sorry. I can't find no notes. Yes, I don't read the book. I want to encourage somebody else.
Yes.
That all you gotta do is take up the shield of faith with the boss in the middle. Shout Jesus!
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 I know. Some of y'all got some stuff going on in your life. And the enemy is trying to tell you
come on.
That you won't win.
Jesus.
But I'm here to let you know that through God, all things are possible.
Yes.
I don't care, prophetess, what the scans say.
Yes.
I don't care what the doctors say.
Yes.
Doesn't matter to me
Jesus.
What the surgeons say.
Yes.
The technician can see and look yes. at all they want to. But I'm telling you
yes.
that the God I serve,
yes.
He's able.
Able.
He's able,
able.
To do everything,
everything.
But fail.
But
the God we serve
yes.
is able,
able.
To do the impossible.
Yes.
Who just take up?
Yes.
Take it up.
Take it up.
Your shield of faith.
Yes.
Push them back.
Yes.
Just your shield of faith.
Yes.
You can knock the enemy back.
Yes.
Whatever dark he show your bring your way.
Yes.
Lift it up.
Yes.
Block it.
Yes.
And guess what?
Yes.
It will rebound.
Yes.
In other words, it'll go back
yes.
to where it came from.
Yes.
That's why.
Come on.
The Bible teaches us in principle
yes.
that the trap you set for me
yes.
Jesus.
Jesus.
Come on.
In essence
yes.
you setting it for yourself
yes. Yes.
See because my God
yes.
will help me
yes.
to recognize the trap
yes.
and when you fling that dart all I got to do
yes.
is take up
yes.
go ahead
Pastor.
Go ahead.
My shield of faith
yes.
and that ditch
yes.
that you dug for me
yes.
you might as well get ready
yes.
and make yourself comfortable
yes.
because that's your home
yes.
not mine
yes.
come on here
yes.
Have your way, Holy
yes.
Jesus.
Take up the shield of faith
yes.
I know
yes.
Hey, Pastor, you just don't understand.
Jesus.
Yes, I do.
Yes,
you don't know what I'm going through. You don't know the report I got. But I'm standing
yes,
here.
Yes, yes, yes.
I'm standing
yes,
here.
Yes.
Breathing just fine.
Yes, 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 yes.
Running around the sanctuary.
Yes, yes,
yes. Trusting my God.
Yes,
yes, yes. Say it.
I will live.
Yes.
And not die.
Yes,
I will
yes,
declare the works of the Lord.
Yes,
thank you, God.
Yes.
You know, I trust God, saints
come
of God.
On, come on.
And I believe God.
Yes.
He gave me a vision.
Yes, He did.
Yes, He did.
Yes, He did.
He gave me a vision.
Yes.
An elder and I, it is our belief
yes.
that God
yes.
is going to allow.
Yes, He is.
He's going to allow us.
Yes, yes, yes.
To see that vision
yes,
come to fruition.
Yes, he will. Yes, he will.
Oh, in the name of Jesus, I will see the safe house.
Yes, sir,
oh, I can't put it all out there. Let
yes.
me be quiet because you know sometimes you know the enemy like to.
Monitor.
So I can't. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yes, right.
But y'all got the vision.
Yeah.
Y'all just took the vision home the other night.
Yeah.
Look out and see how God is.
Yes, yes,
he's strategic in what he does.
Jesus.
So y'all got the vision.
Jesus.
Y'all know what God is working on.
Oh,
yes.
And we're just a part of it.
Yes.
And we're believing God.
Yes.
If you are sick today,
come on,
yes.
Jesus.
I want to encourage you to take up your shield of faith.
Jesus.
Stop accepting what they say.
Yes.
Come on.
have to embrace it.
Yes, Lord.
Listen.
Go ahead.
You can always say, oh, you got the wrong address.
Jesus.
You got the wrong address. When UPS come, amen, with a package, and I look, well, like, oh, no, that's not for me.
Uh-huh.
You got the wrong address. This is 19 Fairfax. That say 21. This wrong place.
Yeah.
Take it.
Yeah.
So when the enemy come your way, come on. Come on here.
Jesus.
And you know that you know that you know that your God is a healer.
Yeah.
I don't care how many times they try to deliver that thing. Jesus. Say,
Come on.
That's right.
You got the wrong address.
Yeah.
Don't worry about what it looked like. Don't worry about what you have to walk through, because sometimes you got to walk through something to get it back to where. You might have to just drive it back there.
Yes.
Walk it back there. I don't know. But sometimes you have to walk through it to get it back to where it belongs.
Yes.
Doesn't mean that it's yours.
That's it.
It's just taking me a little longer to get it back to where it belongs. Yes. But trust me when I tell you, you do not have to embrace anything.
Jesus.
That's not intended for you.
Yes.
God didn't intend for us to be broken.
Come on,
I know what I'm talking about. God didn't intend for us to be broken. That's God wants us everywhere whole. So that we can do the will of our Father.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus. And I believe him. Thank you, Jesus. And by faith,
yes.
By faith,
yes.
Woo, we're walking in it.
Yes.
No, whatever come your way, lift up.
Yes.
Take it up. Everything else you put on.
Yes.
Listen. And just because you know you got your helmet on, don't mean you want to fight with your head.
That's right.
Okay? Just because you got your helmet on don't mean you going to battle like this.
Right.
Amen? No. You use your shield of faith.
Yeah.
Just because you got on your breastplate don't mean you just walk out there. No. Take it up. Put everything on, but take up the shield of faith. So no matter what come your way. And don't forget who's in the middle.
Yes.
Yeah. There's a knob in the middle that you just hold on to. Oh, yeah. It's called the boss. His name is Jesus. Oh, my God. Because, you know, sometimes the enemy will stand back and fire stuff at you. So you can just kind of block it. But sometimes he will advance on you. See, he's trying to advance on me, prophetess. But I just, you know.
Yes, sir.
And I like to push them back. Just,
there you go.
It just feels good.
Jesus.
Thank you, God. And so you just have to hold on real good. And just walk forward.
Yes.
And just keep pushing them back. Jesus. Keep moving forward. Don't go back. Just keep pushing forward.
Yes.
My God. And my Savior. That's for you and he and you out there.
Yes.
No matter what you're going through. Take up.
Take up
the shield of faith. Can I help y'all a little bit more with that?
Yes.
Now, I told you.
Come on.
These shields that they use,
mm-hmm.
they're about 3.5 feet high, right?
Mm-hmm.
Then they were 3 feet wide,
mm-hmm.
right? And so sometimes the enemy would get up above them on the wall.
Jesus.
So you know what they, come on, prophetess, come here.
Mm-hmm.
So what they would do, come on, AV. What they would do is they would link themselves. Now they got their shields.
Yeah.
Right? So you got them in the front. Come on, Elder, get behind us.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, then you got him in the back.
Mm-hmm.
Come on, Sister Sawyer. Mm-hmm. And you got her in the back.
Mm-hmm.
Right? And so they take mm-hmm. these shields.
Jesus.
And they would form what they call, we're going to lift our arms up together.
Jesus.
They would form what they call a tortoise shell.
Jesus.
And they would lift, because they already got some soldiers on this side
mm-hmm.
blocking. They got some soldiers on this
Jesus.
Side
yes.
blocking.
Right.
The ones
Jesus.
In the back are blocking.
Jesus.
And then you got us in the front,
Jesus.
We're blocking.
Yes.
But then you got a row
Jesus.
In the middle, and they would, come on, hold it up.
Jesus.
They would hold up the shield.
Jesus.
Woo!
Jesus.
Woo!
Jesus.
And so the enemy that's on the wall
Jesus.
Can fire the darts
Woo!
Down from
Jesus.
The wall,
Jesus.
But then they're bouncing off
Jesus.
The top of the shield.
Jesus.
Come on here. All the saints of God, thank y'all.
Jesus.
The saints of God.
Jesus.
If we get together and link our faith with one another, oh my God, we will be protected all around and above. Can't nothing penetrate us. The people of God, we got to get it together. Link our shield. What shield? The shield of faith. Showing up, you got to walk in faith.
Yes.
Walk in the spirit and walk by faith.
Yes.
Take up this shield of faith. so you can ward off these darts of the devil. We win. Jesus told us, said, listen, in this world you're going to have all kinds of trouble. Okay, but you got don't leave it there. Well, you know, he did say we going to have trouble. So what, you going to embrace it? Is that crazy? He just said, he just letting you know. But then he didn't stop there. Just, see, that's why you got to read it for yourself. Read past that.
Thank you, Jesus.
Because he said, yes, in this world you're going to have trouble. But he said, be encouraged. I overcame the world. You in this world, you're going to have trouble, but, y'all shout
but,
he overcame the world. So it don't matter what trouble comes our way.
Jesus
already overcame it. We just have to believe it and walk in it. Walk in victory and walk by faith. Come on, you have to tell by my faith. My faith tells me that I'm here. My faith tells me that I win, that I'm victorious, that I'm an overcomer, that I got my breakthrough, that I have been delivered, that I am healed. By his stripes, I am healed. Thank you, Jesus. I don't know about y'all. But Jesus did not, in my book, he didn't get beat for nothing. By his stripes, I am healed. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. And it don't matter to me what I got to walk through, because guess what? Let me tell y'all about this God we serve. Even if you have to walk through it, and you got to walk it back to where it came from, guess what? He said, I'll never leave you. Now, I know in context, he's talking about, lo, I am with you.
That's right.
Right?
Yeah.
But he did say, even in the Old Testament, I'll never leave you.
Neither
will I forsake you. So even if I have to walk through it, he's right there.
Yes, he is.
And wherever he is, oh my God, thank you, Holy Spirit. I got to walk on this one. Wherever he is, there's life. Wherever he is, there is life. So if Jesus is walking with me, prophetess, death can't take hold.
Yes, sir.
Can't be there.
Thank you, Jesus.
Can't be there.
The only way it can take hold is if you leave him. Other than that,
we win.
We are overcoming. We already have eternal life. Eternal life is living in us. Come on, y'all didn't know that?
Yes, it is.
Eternal life is living in us. Thank you, God. Come on here. Come on, y'all got to remember who you are and whose you are. Oh, my God and my Savior. Thank you, God. We win.
We
are overcomers. And I want y'all throughout this day, don't forget. Yes, you are dressed in the full armor of God. But wherever you go, take it up. Take up your shield of faith. Stop accepting this mess from the devil. Been in service, been in the presence of God. Folk ought to know you've been in the presence of God. You ought to smell like you've been in smoke. You ought to, somebody ought to, wait a minute. Where you been? Well, you mean where I've been? something sweet. Where were you today? That's the presence of God. I've been in the presence of God. That's what you smell on me. That's what you see. This shouldn't just stop when you get in your cars and go home. Let that devil know. I got something today that can't nobody take from me. I'm walking by faith. I'm walking in the spirit. And I'm going to take up my shield all day. Every day from this time forward. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, my God. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus. Lord God, we thank you for your word on today, God. We thank you for your presence. We thank you for your power. We thank you, Lord God, that you know all things. We thank you for each and every soul that is listening right now, God, that is under the sound of my voice. God, I pray in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
Yes, yes.
God, that you would touch in a special way, God. In the name of Jesus. Wherever you are right now in this sanctuary, and if you're online, Zoom, Facebook, wherever, YouTube, I want you to get on your heart what you need God to do for you in this moment. Father, in the name of Jesus, you know the heart of every man, woman, boy, and girl. You know their thoughts are far off. You are the provider of our needs. You are the healer of all diseases, all afflictions and diseases. We thank you right now, God, that your healing virtue is going forth even now in the name of Jesus. God, I thank you that you're blessing those finances on their behalf, God. In the name of Jesus, that family will not go without God, but you're making a way out of no way, God. I thank you. I thank you, Father, that the keys are being handed, God, and they will have a roof over their heads, God. In the name of Jesus, I thank you, God. I thank you, Lord, that you're canceling out that disease that tried to take hold, God. I thank you.
In the name of Jesus.
I thank you, God. I see it in the spirit, God. I thank you for bringing back that wayward child. And I see God sending these wayward children home in droves. God, we thank you. Nothing's too hard for you, God. We bless you and we thank you. I thank you, Lord God, that you're regulating heartbeats now, God. In the name of Jesus. Regardless of what the EKG says, God, we thank you for healing, God. In the name of Jesus. I thank you, God, that you're regulating blood sugars, Lord God. I thank you, God, that Raymond's hemoglobin is going up now, God. In the name of Jesus. Cover him in your blood, God. Transfuse him with your blood, God. In the name of Jesus. God, we love you. We thank you, God, for looking on those that are grieving, God. You're walking them through the grieving process, God. Thank you for being a comforter, Holy Spirit. You are our comforter, and we thank you today. We thank you, God, for all things. All things, God. In the name of Jesus. You're making ways out of no way, God. We bless you, Lord. We thank you for Deacon Andre, God. For how you're touching his body now, God. In the name of Jesus. We thank you for how you're strengthening him now, God. In the name of Jesus. Lord, we love you. We give you the glory. All the honor.
Yes.
We thank you for our bishop.
Yes.
Bishop Jones, God.
Yes.
We thank you for his wife.
Yes.
Mother Jones, God.
Yes.
We thank you for how you're keeping them, God.
Yes.
That they will not go in lack, but you will provide every need, God.
Yes.
And that you will do exceeding abundantly.
Yes.
Above all they can ask or even
yes.
think.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus. And not for them only, God, but you're doing it for all your people, God, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we bless you for this ministry. And we thank you for each and every one that's taking part and that's members here, God. I lift them up to you now, God, in the name of Jesus. Every member, God, from the oldest to the youngest, I lift them up before you, God, in the name of Jesus. I lift up their families to you, God, in the name of Jesus. And I thank you for how you're keeping them, God. I thank you for how you're blessing them, God. I thank you for how you're making ways for them, God, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, God. I thank you for how you're drawing us together in unity and in love, in the name of Jesus, helping us to walk out your word where it says iron sharpens iron.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus. Hey! Oh God, we love you.
Yes.
We thank you.
Thank you. And we praise you. In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Let the words of my mouth.
And
the meditation of my heart. Be acceptable in thy sight.
O Lord,
my strength,
my strength and my redeemer.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.